At a country fair in 1906 in the south of England, they held a contest to see who could best guess the weight of a certain cow they had there. And a lot of people entered the contest, over 800 in fact. What was interesting was that even though their guesses ranged from high to low, hundreds of pounds off from each other, a statistician named Sir Francis Galton calculated that the median guess, so if he ordered the guesses from low to high and looked at the middle one, was actually within 1% of the actual weight of the cow. The cow's weight was 1,198 pounds, and the median guess was only 9 pounds too high. So he was pretty interested by this phenomenon, and he called it vox populi, which means the voice of the people. And I'm curious to know if it works, so today we're gonna go find out. How many Skittles? 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 How many Skittles are in this container?
So I'm gonna guess 275.
1500.
I'm gonna go with 1353.
2500. All the time, keep saying like this.
2500. And I'm guessing based on what I feel like is in a bag of Skittles.
2,225.
I guess 713.
52!
3,000!
2,000?
500.
I'm gonna guess 1750.
I'm just
gonna
say
17,000. I'm gonna
guess 2,000.
I have no interest in holding it because that actually doesn't do anything for me.
There has to be at least 50
per row. Well, you have to think in patterns. I think in patterns.
It does seem like a lot. I'm sorry, is this taking way too long?
All the time.
It seems 1250 seems too many. I would say 1250.
All the time.
What I want you to realize is that each of these guesses is independent and individual. So no guess is dependent on another guess, and that's what makes the wisdom of the crowd work, supposedly. The variation that comes between different people actually helps at the end of the day to produce an average, accurate answer. So you might think that working together in a group is beneficial, bouncing ideas off of one another, but that's actually not the case. What usually happens in a group setting is that the person with the loudest voice, or the highest status, or even just the person who speaks first, can sway a whole conversation in a certain direction that they choose. Watch actually what happens in this next clip, where one of our participants does just that, bases her judgment off of the two that came before hers.
Okay. I'm gonna go with 1,500 because I wanna guess in between the two of them, and that's my answer.
So yes, we can reap the benefits of the crowd's wisdom, but only if each component and voice of that crowd is independent and individual. One example of this exactly is in the game show Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. I'm sure you're familiar with this, but Ask the Audience is just an example of the wisdom of the crowd in action.
Today, I think this might be a good time to ask the audience.
I guess I'll probably have to ask the audience.
I'd like to ask the audience.
I think I'm going to ask the audience.
Can I ask the audience?
Can I ask the audience?
It's the one and only Digo Double G.
Over the many years that the show has been on air, contestants have only gotten the questions right about 65% of the time, and the audience, on the other hand, has had a 91% success rate. It's not just in game shows, though, that combined forecasts and averaged opinions are better than individual ones. If you go to macroeconomic forecasting, there's one clear example of this, too. One example of this is the Blue Chip Economic Indicator Survey, which actually takes the voices of over 70 different economists and merges them into one aggregate forecast. It takes voices from academic institutions to major banks to consulting firms and averages their voice out into one census. Over a span of 15 years, this survey has performed better than any one of the individuals who comprise it. All right, so I just counted up the number of Skittles and they were so close to 1,500. And in total, we have 1,499 Skittles, and then four little duds right here. At this point, you're probably still wondering, did the experiment work today? That is what I want to know. And in fact, it did not. The median guess from our crowd was 1,000 Skittles. And as you just saw, the actual amount of Skittles was 1,499. If you ask me why this didn't work, I have a couple ideas. Perhaps our sample size is not large enough. At 130 people, there's still enough room for variation that can throw things off. But 1,499, that's still a very big gap. What went wrong? Well, one thing that definitely could have been the case is that, aside from the median being 1,000, our mode was also 1,000. Out of a population of 130, 10% of people interviewed guessed 1,000.
1,000.
1,000.
1,000.
1,000.
If you think about it, 1,000 isn't an unreasonable guess. There weren't about 100 Skittles in the jar, and there weren't about 10,000 Skittles in the jar. So going to 1,000, the closest power of 10 to our answer, is a pretty good judgment. And at that point, I don't know if our participants had a great enough incentive to refine their guess. As you see, sometimes science doesn't work out as expected. Sometimes you'll find data that confirms a theory, and sometimes you won't. But if you think there's a flaw in my experiment, please let me know in the comments below, and I would be very willing to retry this. But otherwise, I hope you enjoyed this first video of my channel. If you liked it, like this video though. And if you want to stay in touch and see what's next, click right here to subscribe. See you then.
All the time.